Today we're taking a look at the VCU versus Oregon match, which is happening on Saturday, March 20th, 2021, 9:57 p.m., and giving you my betting tips and predictions in general on this game. Welcome back to High Stakes, let's get straight into it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to get notified as soon as we release these sport prediction videos. The VCU Rams and Oregon Ducks will match up in the first round of the West region on Saturday night. The loser of this game will go home and the winner advances to face the winner of the Grand Canyon/Iowa game. The Rams have a 19-7 record and captured the 10th seed by losing the Atlantic 10 Finals against the St. Bonaventure Bonnies 74-65 on Sunday. The Oregon Ducks have a 20-6 record and are the 7th seed after losing in the Pac-12 semifinals to the Oregon State Beavers 75-64 last Friday. These two programs are similar on the defensive side of the floor, so it will be interesting to see which offense can get going and take advantage. Let's take a deeper dive into the matchup to decide where we should place our wagers. VCU needed to make a deep run in the Atlantic 10 tournament to feel good about its chances on Selection Sunday. The Rams were able to make that happen, beating Dayton and Davidson to get to the title game. They were unable to hang with the top seed in the conference, losing to St. Bonaventure by 9 points. Their non-conference slate included a win over Memphis and losses to West Virginia and Penn State. They are an average offensive team, listed at number 118 in KenPom's adjusted efficiency ratings. Oregon is an average defensive squad, coming in at number 75 in adjusted efficiency. Sophomore guard Nashawn Hyland is one of the best guards in the country, averaging 19.5 points and 4.7 rebounds per game. He scored 21 points and grabbed 6 boards in 27 minutes against St. Bonaventure in the Atlantic 10 title game. Hyland poured in 30 points against Dayton in the quarterfinal and is capable of leading VCU to a win, but he dealt with a foot injury down the stretch of the season. Junior forward Vince Williams Jr. is the only other player in double figures, averaging 10.6 points and 5.2 rebounds. The Oregon Ducks have been depending on the production from senior forward Eugene Amorei this season. He is averaging 16.7 points, 5.2 rebounds, 2.2 assists, 0.5 blocks, and 1.5 steals in 30.3 minutes per game. He is shooting well as he is 47% from the floor, 38.4% from the three-point line, and 76.1% from the free throw line. In his last game against the Beavers, Amorei played 35 minutes and finished with 14 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists, 2 blocks, and 5 steals. If he can figure out how to reproduce this performance, it will be a good look for the Ducks. The 10-seed VCU Rams come into the NCAA championship with an overall record of 19-7 while finishing conference play with a 19-7 record. VCU earned the 2-seed in the A-10 championship and picked up wins against Dayton and Davidson. However, the Rams could not secure the A-10 championship after being defeated by the St. Bonaventure Bonnies 74-65 this past Sunday. VCU struggled offensively against the tough St. Bonaventure defense and could not fight back after the Bonnies took a 55-39 lead with 10-11 left in regulation. VCU shot 40.7% from the field and 33.3% from beyond the arc, while St. Bonaventure shot 40.3% from the field and 42.1% from beyond the arc. VCU won the turnover battle by a 10-9 margin, however, was out-rebounded by the Bonnies by a 42-32 margin. Leading the way for the Rams was Nashawn Hyland, who had 21 points, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists. VCU enters this NCAA tournament first round matchup at 19-7 so far. The Rams are 2-1 in their last 3 and coming off a loss to St. Bonaventure. As for Oregon, they're 20-6 this year. The Ducks lost to Oregon State last Friday in the conference tourney. Check back all season long for free college basketball picks at Sports Chat Place. VCU has remained a consistent team this year, and they're yet to lose consecutive games. The Rams are just 3-3 in their last 6 outings. However, VCU has beaten St. Louis, Dayton and Davidson while otherwise falling to George Mason, Davidson and St. Bonaventure in that time. So here are my betting suggestions for that game. Oregon got shocked in the second round of the Pac-12 tournament, and that stinging loss to their rival, Oregon State, should refocus Oregon on the task at hand. It likely dropped them down a few seeds in the tournament as they are better than a seventh seed. On the other hand, VCU is probably seated a little too high at number 10. VCU plays great defense but is offensively challenged, but it's easier to play great defense in the A-10, a mid-major, than it is against a stacked Oregon team from the Pac-12. I love Oregon here to win easily. They have two great players, Amari and Duarte, and just have a lot of offensive firepower. They are also solid defensively. They are clearly the better team and should win easily against VCU, which lost in the A-10 finals. Take the Ducks giving up the points. My first betting advice for you is to pick Oregon -5. The Ducks are a well-rounded team with five players who score in double digits, most notably Chris Duarte, who may break out this tournament. Oregon had the best three-point percentage in the Pac-12, 38%, with weapons spread all over the court. The biggest difference maker in this game is going to be the turnover battle. VCU typically creates a lot of turnovers, ranking fourth nationally in steals, but the Ducks don't turn the ball over. The Rams lead the Atlantic 10 in both fouls and turnovers with their aggressive playing style. Neither Nashawn Highland nor Vince Williams looked 100% in the Atlantic 10 championship, which is cause for concern. I'm laying the points with the Oregon Ducks in what I anticipate to be a double-digit win over this young VCU team. The 7-seed Oregon Ducks come into the NCAA championship with an overall record of 20-6 while finishing conference play with a 14-4 record. Oregon earned the 1-seed in the Pac-12 championship and picked up a 91-73 win over Arizona State in the quarterfinals. However, the Ducks could not reach the Pac-12 championship game after being upset by the 5-seed Oregon State Beavers, 75-64, in the semifinals. Oregon struggled defensively against their in-state rivals and could not fight back after the Beavers took a 58-41 lead with 10:55 left in regulation. Oregon shot 41.8% from the field and 24.0% from beyond the arc, while Oregon State shot 50.0% from the field and 52.6% from beyond the arc. Oregon won the turnover battle by a 16-9 margin. However, the Ducks were out-rebounded by the Beavers by a 38-24 margin in the loss. Leading the way for the Ducks was Eugene Amari, who had 14 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists, 2 blocks, and 5 steals. On the season, Oregon is averaging 74.4 PPG on 47.2% shooting from the field. The Ducks are averaging 8.4 three-pointers per game on 37.9% shooting from beyond the arc. My second betting advice for you is to pick over 137.5. Good luck to all of you. That's it for this video. Stay tuned and stay safe for the next betting tips and advice.